now I have to, first of all, to know us, to know me. I'm an architect. I'm also a teacher to the University of Architecture and Urbanism in Bucharest, and I choose for you some projects to know something about our activity. There are projects designed, I know, for we are speaking for a long period, maybe 15, 20 years, and I start with some projects. This is a project that's a big house on the lake near Bucharest. In the winter, the model is this is the model was made in 96. Another house in 2000. The plans. Another house in 2004, if I remember well, in Târgu Jiu is the city of Brancusi. In Romanian is Brâncuși, the great sculptor. This is the north facade with the entrance. This is the south facade, the evening, of course. Some plants. This is, there are some dwellings near Bucharest. It's another house on the border of the lake in Bucharest with in concrete, with a winter garden in the middle, because the owners asked me for the beginning. They have they need a winter garden, and the concept was around this demand. A view from the lake, the plan. It's another house. The owner was a Romanian who came from United States, and he wanted a house with a traditional roof, let's say. And I started to think how to avoid to make a house for Hansel and Gretel. This is the result. All the let's say the daily functions are upstairs, the living room and dining room, because it's to a border of interesting lake in Bucharest. Some plans. A house to the border of the seaside, Black Sea, in Romania, near Constanța. Under construction. This is in 2008. Another house in the middle of Bucharest, with it's conceived with a courtyard in the middle, and all the house it's open to this interior garden, let's say. A view from the interior garden, and all the interior it's. It's a kind of pond with water. This is another house in Sibiu. Sibiu is in Transylvania. It's with Austrian influences. And I wanted to create a house very minimalistic, let's say. And I use the copper on the roof and also to the facades. This is the back interior. The house is conceived with half levels, some plans, and offices building in Bucharest. And now a project is already done. It's an, in a cultural center in Bucharest, but he is built on the borders of an ancient cinema hall, and we have to make something bigger, and this is a result. In the front, it's a media mesh which make some economy of energy because it's functioning like a shadow protection. And in the same time, it's a media mesh. You have in Milan a similar mesh in Plaza del Duomo. This is the model. These are some an offices building in Bucharest with brick, ventilated facades. It's still under construction, 3 years. And this is a house, very interesting, and maybe it's connected with our pavilion, because it's a house for an owner, which is making bio agriculture in Tulcea, because in Tulcea it's a town near Delta, Danube Delta, which is very young land. And this creates a possibility to have a bio agriculture for a very, very good quality. The entrance is it's here, because the hill is quite tall, and the entrance is here, and the garages, and we enter by a tunnel. And after we get the elevator to go in the top of the house. You have here a section, the entrance, and the elevator and the house. And they are looking to a lake. It's very, very nice view from there. This is a basement, let's say. The upper level, and here is already done the basement with the garages here, the entrance, the tunnel, and the elevator. This is a house under construction now. It's an offices building. These very important parts hanged up. It's quite a performance in Romania, because in Romania, like in Italy, there are very strong earthquakes. That's the model and the building under construction. And we made a lot of little things in the same time. Interiors is a place for arts. A chair, an armchair. It's quite comfortable, believe me. A sofa. And now we start to explain about our pavilion, which is we work together with Adest, with my colleague Radu Petre Nastase, which is here, and of course with Ministry of Foreign Affairs. We have here Mr. General Commissioner Georgian Gervasie, who helped us a lot to finish this project. And now I have to read a little bit, because it will be fast and easier for you to understand. Romanian Pavilion is located close to the intersection between Cardo and Decumano, with the access from Decumano Boulevard, with Spain to southwest, Mexico to east, and France to the north, on the other side of Decumano Boulevard. One of the objectives aimed by a Romanian Pavilion and Expo Milan 2015, Feeding the Planet Energy for Life, is to present a viable solution for the third millennium technology and the urban living to cohabit with the natural living still so present in Romania. This harmony between nature and non-invasive technologies might put Romania on a very important spot on the bio-European agriculture market, a domain that conquers more and more fields despite the pressure for an agriculture focused on quantity. We believe this must be a road to follow when outlining the future of Romanian agriculture. We aim to reflect the actual situation and position of the country, which led us to an image that involves moderation, modesty, and balance, elements that define the Romanian traditional architecture as well. We believe that our country has the potential to develop in harmony and intimacy with the traditional values and customs. The first element to the now there are some beautiful images made by a Romanian, which is here in an architect, a Romanian architect, which is in the auditorium, Mr. Costin Irimia. Very beautiful images from Romania. And now it's a traditional house in Romania. Some landscapes from Danube Delta, which is very important because the water surrounding our pavilion, it's an element which symbolizes the presence of the Danube Delta in Romania. Our pavilion, it's here, it's here. Yes, here, because here it's Spain. It's a situation plan and the entrance. The first element presented to the public at the entrance of the pavilion is the water that flutes into a pond symbolizing the Danube Delta. Now it's very small because the organizer told us we had to renounce on it because there are some problems with the structure of shade sails and their structure, and we have to make it smaller. Is the water flutes into a pond symbolizing the Danube Delta, natural an element unique in Europe and representative for Romanian geographic diversion. The water feature has also the purpose to create an expansion between the public space of the exhibition and the entrance in the Romanian pavilion, preparing the visitor to embrace another atmosphere, stepping into a different world. The water is also a symbol of purifying matter that acts as a propensity towards a better world that Romania aspires to. The main access is made from Decumanus Boulevard on water-resistant thick wooden path. Another images. In the access area, the ground floor continues with several vertical bars that are here. That border the entrance bridge. Their setup material and form suggested a pan pipe, musical instrument deeply connected to Romanian culture. This image is completed by characteristic sound triggered by movement sensors meant to attract the attention of the visitors. Once the visitor enters the ground floor, designed as a neutral volume in which the light is filtered by the some tall and thin stratified wooden pieces that serve as structural elements as well, the guest will encounter a space similar to a neutral white box that shelters technologies as LED displays that cover the interior walls. In fact, all the walls in the interior are media walls of the ground floor, and where you can hear and see in an interactive manner data about Romania, landscape, traditions, custom, cultures. An important element is represented by the multifunctional hall that is also covered with LED screens that can be synchronized with the events that take place inside. Another images. This is a pan pipe. This is Pan pipe because Pan was a god in Greek mythology, and this instrument is deeply linked with Balkanic culture, but in Romania it's a very important instrument. This is a plan, and this is a multi-purpose hall about time. Talk some facades. The multifunctional hall can function either as a distinct closed space for conferences or other events, or it can be opened partially or total in order to participate as a whole with the other ground floor spaces. The areas adjacent to the multifunctional hall can be customized by specific themes, biodiversity with the commercial area, agriculture and green energy, fruits and vegetables, culture and tradition, culinary arts and its product display and market. The visitation path is designed so the images on the LED monitors are correlated with transited areas. This is our facades, the sections and the interior. And here is the multipurpose hall about already spoke. And these are lamellas, which are serving also to make some shadow in the interior. And at the same time, it's a structure for our pavilion. It's very important to speak about Romanian traditional architecture, because the restaurant, which is on the upper level, it's, let's say, a reloaded traditional house surrounding by a garden. Because we wanted to bring in here into the exposition a corner of Romania, because Romania is very interesting for his nature. I told in all these interviews before, in Romania there are half of wild animals in Europe, and despite the deforesting, the strong deforesting, we still have important surfaces of forest, virgin forests. And we have to talk a little bit about traditional architecture. Romanian traditional architecture is one of mediation. This is very important, the mediation in our traditional architecture. When I say this, I mean that fences are in general ephemeral. Made of wood of low height can easily be passed over. They are simply a symbol of boundary. The support to support this ideal, the importance of gateways is expressed, which in some regions like Maramureș or Gorj have a monumental character by being decorated with Christian and pre-Christian symbols and emphasize the transcending from exterior space to inside. In contradiction with the enclosures mentioned above, which are very easy to pass. Their importance is even more emphasized thanks to the fact that the cart's entrance is different from the people's one, and to the fact that they have a roof which can shelter people, facilitating socialization. Traditional household, and I say this for the most of the areas, is composed by many constructions, but the dwelling as principal element presents the same mediation between exterior and interior space. Given this, the material element corresponds very, very well with the English concept in between, is a porch, which is an exterior space but covered. What impresses most at this element is the importance given to it in, and I speak of the way the pillars and the beams are modulated, like true sculptures. Not by accident, Mario Botta, during his visit in 2008, I believe, at the National Village Museum, said that he just understood why Brancusi is a Romanian. And he said this because the wooden cuts, the shapes, and the language is resumed in many of artists' sculptures. Actually, besides the porch, the very generous eaves which surround the construction create a certain kind of mediation between space, between the exterior of the building, this is very important, the exterior of the building, and the outer space of the building. This is a theory of well-known Renato De Fusco about building in general, because he said the building as an exterior of it and the outer space of it. And in Romanian architecture, this is going very, very, very well. Furthermore, energy entering the house dwelling, we find another transition room called anteroom, tinda in Romanian, which jump us to the kitchen and to the room. Given that we resume, we have the gateway, just a symbol, which interrupts a fence that's around only symbolic, then the yard, the porch, the anteroom, and finally the rooms with domestic functions. Romanian architecture is one that integrates itself into the nature. It's an architecture of which one great poet and philosopher, Romanian philosopher, said that it's pittoresque and resonates with the nature. It's not one which makes order into the nature. Romanian architecture is extroverted because houses do not form an alignment to the street. They are distant from it and open entirely towards the yard. Without having other Western European houses' character, where the private life happens in the backyard, sheltered from the passers' views. In the case of the upper floor restaurant house, now we have to pass a little bit through these images. This is a corn shelter, a gate. This is a gate. Yes, it's a village museum. Some image from the porch before, and now the roof, thatched roof. Some stairs, very interesting. Reed. And now we are talking about the upper level. In the case of the upper floor restaurant house, we aim to take some formulas from traditional architecture, materials like and compositions like wooden beams and their jointing forming the walls, the reed roof on wooden structure, but also using a glazing corresponding to new times and allows a more direct relationship with the surroundings garden. Generous eaves that protect the walls and the space around the construction is a replica of the traditional porch. Deeply involved in its substance, the traditional Romanian architecture, it's in fact a classical one because the influence of the Greek temples, they are translated into an wooden architecture because the columns before the porch, it's an echo of the ancient Greek temples. This is our proposal on 3D. I hope it's similar with what happens now in the construction site. And this is a concept regarding our concept from the beginning regarding the principal theme of Milan 2015. And we have some photovoltaic. We conceived this pavilion with some photovoltaic panels, some solar panels, and to reuse the water from rainfall. But owing to the budget and the short time remains, we have to renounce on the photovoltaic panels and the solar panel. These are some images, Grace. The kindness of our friend Costini Rimia sent to us from the building's site. This is the ground floor. The external stairs, which permit to access to the restaurant without the schedule of the ground floor. You can enter anytime. The restaurant. The beams, joints, and making the exterior walls with glass walls in the interior, and the garden is at the beginning. We hope it will grow up. The kitchen, which is split out in, is split on the in the roof, and some light and shadow in the interior, and this assembly, wood and glass, who permit to view the garden surrounding our pavilion. In fact, we tried to bring to Expo 2015 some technology which is closer to the Romanians regarding software and computers, and a corner of our country with a garden, some plants, and a traditional architecture. Thank you very much.